Taxonomy is one of the oldest field of biological sciences. The three main functions of taxonomy are identification, nomenclature, and classification. Identification is determination of a plant as being identical to or different from a previously known plant. Identification is generally done by comparing the characters of the plant with an authentic herbarium specimen or with the help of keys in flora. Nomenclature is providing a scientific name to an identified plant. This is necessary for proper communication and identification of a taxon. The name is given in accordance with a set of rules framed by International Botanical Congress, which meets at regular intervals. Binomial nomenclature should be followed for naming all the plants. This means the plant should have two names. First name represents genus and second is species. After nomenclature, the classification is done for the plant. Classification means placing of plants into a hierarchy of ranks or categories such as species, genus, family and so on. This is known as classification. Now we will see what are the principles, rules and recommendations of ICBN that one should follow while naming the plants. Learning objectives are introduction to ICBN, International Botanical Congress, principles, rules and recommendations, and conclusions. By the end of this topic, you will be able to learn what is the necessity of forming these principles, rules and recommendations, and also the rules to be followed while naming an identified plant. During the middle of 18th century, plant names were polynomials. That means the name of the plant used to be with several words. Later, Gaspard Bahin was the scientist who came up with the novel idea of having two names for every plant. He proposed names of a plant in which first name represents genus and second name represents species. This is known as binomial system of nomenclature. This was first implemented by Carolus von Linnaeus. The naming of plants was first proposed by Linnaeus in 1737 in Critica Botanica and then 1751 in Philosophia Botanica. Later, binomial system was first applied by Linnaeus in his Species Plantarum in 1753. In 1813, a detailed set of rules regarding plant nomenclature was given by A.P. de Candolle. Later, these rules were framed to serve as guide to botanists. The discovery of a number of plants in the middle of 18th century required the development of an order and stability in plant nomenclature. And this is, you can see, this is the photograph of Carolus von Linnaeus, who first implemented the binomial system of nomenclature. And this is the book name, Species Plantarum. In this book only, he first used the binomial system of nomenclature for naming the plants. International Botanical Congress. Now we will see how many and where these International Botanical Congress were held to frame a set of international rules to be followed while naming a plant. The first International Botanical Congress was held at Paris in 1867 and which was convened by Alfonso de Candolle. It is also known as Paris Code. Botanical Congress were held in 1892, 1905, 1907 and 1910. And resolved the numerical problem and established internationally acceptable rules. In 1935, the 5th International Congress was held at Cambridge, England. The code came into existence that was international in function. With many changes, 16th International Code adopted in 1999 at St. Louis, Missouri, where 17th International Botanical Congress was held at Vienna, and 18th International Botanical Congress was held at Melbourne in 2011. Whereas the 17th International Botanical Congress, which was held in Vienna, it took in 2005. And recently, 19th International Botanical Congress was held in Shenzhen in 2017. The code is divided into three parts: principles, rules, and recommendations. These principles form the basis for botanical nomenclature. The six principles are: first one is botanical nomenclature is independent of zoological nomenclature. That means botanical nomenclature is different, whereas the zoological nomenclature is different. The application of names of taxonomic group is determined by means of nomenclature type. This means while giving a name to any plant or any plant species, they should follow the nomenclature type. The nomenclature of a taxonomic group is based upon priority of publication. While giving the name to the species, the priority of publication is very, very important. That means which name is published prior, that name will be given to that particular plant. Each taxonomic group can bear only one correct name, that is a valid and effectively published name. That means here, any plant species which is going to get a name should have only one correct name. That name should be validly and effectively published. Scientific names of taxonomic groups are treated as Latin regardless of their derivation. The rules of nomenclature are retroactive unless expressly limited. This means that the rules apply to work done before the acceptance of these rules. Rules and recommendations. Taxonomic ranks. Taxonomic unit of any rank is called taxon. The term taxon was first introduced in Stockholm Code, which was held in 1952. Taxon refers to a taxonomic group of any rank. Species is the basic taxon. The other taxa of higher rank in ascending series are genus, family, order, class, division, and kingdom. The taxon may be further subdivided by adding the prefix sub as subfamily, subgenus, subspecies, etc. By introducing supplementary terms like tribe can be introduced between family and genus, section between genus and species, variety or form below the species, we can use this term. Now we will see names of taxa. The name of taxa should be given particularly suffix with, for example, order suffix with ALES, family ACEAE, in the same manner division with phyta, and class EAE, okay. Like that only. Some families. Earlier, the names of these families were treated as exceptions because of their long usage. Alternate names were given to these families. Here you can see Compositae. Earlier, the Asteraceae family was known as Compositae. This Compositae name is now it is changed into Asteraceae. Graminae, now it is known as Poaceae. Labiatae is now called as Lamiaceae. Palmae is now called as Ericaceae. And Umbelliferae, Apiaceae. Cruciferae, Brassicaceae. Leguminosae as Fabaceae. And Guttiferae as Clusiaceae. These are the eight families. Those were given alternate names. Typification. Article 7 of ICBN code states that the application of names of taxa of the rank of family or below is determined by means of nomenclature type. The names of different taxonomic groups are based on the type method. All taxonomic groups will be based on nomenclature types. The nomenclature type is a herbarium sheet of the plant, which was used by the author to give the authentic description of the plant. If the specimen cannot be preserved, the type may be description or the figure of the plant. The type of the genus is species. The type of the family is genus. Different kinds of types. First one is holotype. It is the specimen or element used by the author as the main nomenclature type. Next, isotype. It is duplicate specimen of the holotype. It is also collected from the same locality on the same date and time. Paratype. A specimen other than holotype and isotype is called paratype. The specimen may bear a different field number as is collected from different localities by different collectors. Next one is syntype. The specimen which is the basis of new taxon when no holotype is designated by author is known as syntype. That means author will not designate, author may forget or he may not designate by because of some reasons maybe. Then the specimen which is on the basis of new taxon, when no holotype is designated by the author, then that specimen will be considered as syntype. Next is neotype. It is a specimen selected to serve as the nomenclature type when all the original material is lost. Lectotype. It is a specimen selected from the original material and which serves as a nomenclature type when no holotype was designated at the time of publication. Principle of priority. Article 11 and 12, each taxon can have only one correct name and that should be the earliest published name. For this, 1st May 1753 is taken as the earliest date for all plants except algae and fungi. The International Botanical Congress held in Melbourne in 2011 July redesignated ICBN as ICN. That means International Code of Botanical Nomenclature is now redesignated as International Code of Nomenclature. This ICN is for algae, fungi and also for plants. For example, now here we will see what is principle of priority. A genus name as Polygala Linnaeus. Linnaeus, he named that particular genus as Polygala in 1753. In the same manner, same genus was named as Polygala neck in 1768 and Polygaloides Augusti. He is the author who named this in 1770. According to this principle of priority, Polygala L is the name for the genus. Author citation. Article 46 states that the name of a taxon is valid only when author's name is cited. Usually, author's name is abbreviated or cited after the name of a plant. For example, if the plant name is given by Linnaeus, then we'll put the author name as L. That means definitely the author who described that plant name should be named as abbreviated after the name of that plant. When father and son are both authors, the letter F follow the name of the son. For example, Impatiens Thomsoni, the plant name is given by both father and son. That time they cite like this, H-O-O-K, hook, dot and F. F is father's name. That means father and son both together might have done work on this particular plant. Here, father is William Jackson Hooker and Joseph Dalton Hooker is the son. When the name is published jointly by two authors, the name should be connected by at or and symbol. For example, Antigonon Leptopus, here Hook and Ornan. That means both they have published this particular name. When a plant is named by one author and validly published by another, the names of both authors are linked together by the word X. Example, Caparis lacyantha. Here, RBREXDC. This meaning, the name is validly published by. Rejection of names. Article 51 to 58 indicate rules for rejection of names. Names must be rejected when nomenclaturally superfluous. If it is a homonym and tautonym, they must be rejected. Synonyms. Synonyms are two types. These are homotypic and heterotypic synonyms. Synonyms are different names for the same plant. For example, Chilocarpus malabaricus and Hunteria atrovirens are the nomenclatural synonyms of Chilocarpus atrovirens, as the type specimen is the same. These are homotypic synonyms. Now we will see what is heterotypic synonyms. For example, Vernonia leucocarpa and Vernonia melanocarpa are taxonomic synonyms, as the two are based on different specimens. Basionym. When a species is described in one genus but transferred to another, later the specific epithet legitimate should be retained. For example, Myrobalanus bellerica is now known as Terminalia bellerica. Myrobalanus bellerica is the basionym of Terminalia bellerica. Homonym. When two or more identical names are given based on different type specimens, they are known as homonyms. The earliest amongst these is legitimate and should be retained. For example, Centranthera indica, if shifted to Limnophila, cannot be named as Limnophila indica because there is already a species with the same name, that is Limnophila indica. In the event of doing so, these will be homonyms. Next, tautonym. It is an illegitimate binomial where the generic name of a name and specific epithet are exactly the same. For example, Malus, Malus. Here, genus is Malus and whereas species also Malus. These type of names are rejected. Effective and valid publication. Articles 29 to 50 deal with the valid publications. A publication is considered as valid only when it satisfies the following conditions. A publication is effective under the code by the distribution of printed matter to botanical institutes, libraries, etc. And which should be accompanied by a Latin diagnosis or reference to a previously published description of the taxon. And that must be accompanied by nomenclatural type. A new name published after 1st January 1953 must have a clear indication of the rank of the taxon concerned. Tautonyms should not be used at all. The code now permits electronic publication of names of new taxa and English or Latin name for the publication. Conclusions. First International Botanical Congress was held at Paris in 1867. The code passed here is known as Paris Code. It is also called as De Candolle Rule. The International Botanical Congress held in Melbourne in 2011, July, redesignated ICBN as ICN. ICBN is International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. Now it is known as International Code of Nomenclature. This International Code of Nomenclature is for algae, fungi and plants. International Botanical Congress held at different places every 6 years. It provides stable method of nomenclature and to reject the names which cause confusion. Latest, that is 19th International Botanical Congress, was held in Shenzhen, China in 2017. The rules of the Shenzhen Code became effective from 26th June 2018. The code now permits electronic publication of names of new taxa and also use of English or Latin name for the publication of new name. Thank you.